ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयम् उदीरयेत्। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराणम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 3 टेक्स्ट 22। अयं तु असभ्यस्तव जन्मनो गृहे श्रुत्वाग्रजांस्ते न्यवधीत् सुरेश्वर। स ते अवतारं पुरुषै समर्पितम् श्रुत्वा धुनैवाभिसरत्युधायुधा। अयम् दिस रास्कल तू बट असभ्य हु इज नॉट सिविलाइज्ड एट ऑल। असुर मीन्स अनसिविलाइज्ड एंड सुर मीन्स सिविलाइज्ड। तब ऑफ योर लॉर्डशिप जन्म दिवार्थ नो आवर गृहे इन टू दि होम श्रुत्वा आफ्टर हियरिंग अग्रजान अग्रजान्ते ऑल दि ब्रदर्स बर्न बिफोर यू न्यवधित किल्ड सुरेश्वर ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ द सूरस द सिविलाइज्ड पर्सन्स सह ही दैट अनसिविलाइज्ड कम्स ते योर अवतारम अपियरेंस पुरुषे बाय हिज लेफ्टनेंट्स संप्रतिम समर्पितम बीइंग इन्फॉर्म्ड ऑफ श्रुत्वा आफ्टर हियरिंग अधुना नाउ एव इंडीड अभिश्रति विल कम इमीडिएटली युधायुधः विथ रेज्ड वेपन्स। ट्रांसलेशन एंड पर्पट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। ट्रांसलेशन ओ माई लॉर्ड द लॉर्ड ऑफ द डेमिगॉड्स आफ्टर हियरिंग द प्रोफेसी दैट यू वुड टेक बर्थ इन आवर होम एंड किल हिम दिस अनसिविलाइज्ड कम्स किल्ड सो मेनी ऑफ योर एल्डर ब्रदर्स एज सून एज ही हियर्स फ्रॉम हिज लेफ्टनेंट्स दैट यू हैव अपियर्ड He will immediately come with weapons to kill you. Purport. Kamsa has here been described as asabhya. means uncivilized or most heinous, because he killed the many children of his sister. When he heard the prophecy that he would be killed by her eighth son, this uncivilized man, Kamsa, was immediately ready to kill his innocent sister on the occasion of her marriage. An uncivilized man can do anything for the satisfaction of his senses. He can kill children, he can kill cows, he can kill brahmanas, he can kill old men. He has no mercy for anyone. According to the Vedic civilization, cows, women, children, old men, and brahmanas should be excused if they are at fault. But asuras, the uncivilized men, do not care about that. At the present moment, the killing of cows and the killing of children is going on unrestrictedly, and therefore this civilization is not at all human. And those who are conducting this condemned civilization are uncivilized asuras. Such uncivilized men are not in favor of the Kamsa, not in the favor of Krishna consciousness movement. As public officers, they declare without hesitation that the chanting of the Hare Krishna movement is a nuisance. Although Bhagavad Gita clearly says, Satatam kirtayantu mam yatantascha drahabrataha. According to this verse, it is the duty of the Mahatmas to chant the Hare Krishna mantra and try to spread it all over the world to the best of their ability. Unfortunately, society is in such an uncivilized state that there are so-called Mahatmas who are prepared to kill cows and children and stop the Hare Krishna movement. Such uncivilized activities were actually demonstrated in opposition to the Hare Krishna movement's Bombay Center. Hare Krishna Land in Mumbai. As Kamsa was not expected to kill the beautiful child of Devaki and Vasudev, the uncivilized society, although unhappy about the advancement of the Krishna consciousness movement, cannot be expected to stop it. Yet, we must face many difficulties in many different ways. Although Krishna cannot be killed, Vasudeva, as the father of Krishna, was trembling because in affection he thought that Kamsa would immediately come and kill his son. Similarly, although the Krishna consciousness movement and Krishna are non-different and no asuras can check it, we are afraid that at any moment the asuras can stop this movement in any part of the world. Om Ajnanam Tamirandhasya Jnanam Janasalakaya Chakhur Unmulitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Swapadantikam Vande Aham Sri Guru Sri Jutapadakamalam Sri Guru Vaishnavansa Sri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahaganam Raghunatham Nitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakha Nitam Sa Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarine जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण। सो दिस वर्स इज स्पोकन बाय द फादर ऑफ कृष्ण वसुदेव। द सिचुएशन इज कृष्ण अपियर्ड इन द जेल दे आर हुयर वसुदेव एंड देवकी वेर दे आर इम्प्रिजन्ड ऑलरेडी बाउंड बाय देयर हैंड्स एंड लेग्स एंड दैट अष्टमी मिड नाइट कृष्ण अपियर्ड यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड ऑलरेडी डिस्क्रिप्शन विथ फुल यूनिफॉर्म विथ ऑल हिज ऑर्नामेंट्स एवरीथिंग इन फुल प्लेयर। फर्स्ट फादर वसुदेव सॉ हिम देवकी वाज स्टिल इन फेंटिंग पोजिशन। सो वसुदेव सॉ द सुप्रीम पर्सन साक्षात नारायण द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड ही हैज स्टडीड इन शास्त्र ही हैज हर्ड अबाउट हिम लॉट। सो वेन द सेम पर्सन हुम अबाउट ही हर्ड ए लॉट स्टडीड ए लॉट सीइंग हिम इन फ्रंट विथ फुल एफुलजेंस एंड फुल डिस्प्ले ऑफ ऑल हिज अपुलेंस एंड अर्नामेंट्स एंड एवरीथिंग द सुप्रीमली हैंडसम चाइल्ड साक्षात नारायण देन वसुदेव कुड नॉट कंट्रोल ही स्टार्टेड डूइंग स्तुति विथ फोल्डेड हैंड्स and this is the last verse of the stuti. So in the concluding verse Vasudeva is telling with folding heart to his son, just new born baby, his father, saying, "O my dear supreme lord, by a fragment of your mercy I could able to understand a drop of your greatness, of your opulence. And by that drop, whatever I could understand by your mercy, that I know that you are the supreme person, you are the supreme controller, you are the supreme proprietor, you are the supreme enjoyer. You, by His sweet will, creating this whole universe, maintaining it, destroying it. By your partial expansion, you sometimes becomes Brahma in help in creation. You become Vishnu, helping in maintenance. You become Rudra, helping in destruction. You are the father of the whole universe, unlimited entities. You telling Bhagavad Gita, Aham Bija Pada Pritaha, I am the seed giving father. You are the real father of everybody, anyone in the whole universe. You are the father. But you are so compassionate. Unlimited mercy, particularly on me, I can't describe it in my words. You decide and you accept me as your father. O Supreme Father, nobody can be father of yours, but you, by your sweet will, you decide to be my son. Not only decide. Now I am seeing you appeared here as my son, as my newborn baby. You are, I am seeing the full-fledged Supreme Lord. You are. You appeared as my son. You are so merciful upon me because you want to give me the post of father. You want me to be the father of yours. You never mind that your father, myself, is imprisoned in conscious jail. Not only imprisoned, this very secured, this 8th time, Kamsa has put all his power, prowess. He has increased the number of security, increased the number of locks and heavy gauge lock and door. All security measures he has taken, and inside this closed room with Devaki, and our hands and legs are also binded. And you never mind, never feel anything. You came inside this jail room. Such a secured jail room, you come inside in the midnight and appeared in front of us as our son. It is no words there to describe your compassion, your mercy upon me, O my Lord. You are so eager to be my child, to make me your father. You are so eager. You didn't mind to come inside this jail room. What can I say? Not only that, you can do anything. I know that you can do anything. Ano raniyan mahato mahiyan. You can be smaller of the smallest. You can be bigger of the biggest. You can do that. But I don't know what I am. You are so eager to be my child. You come inside the jail in this such a case, you never mind, and appeared here in midnight to be our son. Oh my dear Lord, by seeing you appear as my child, I am totally engrossed in fatherly affection. I am in the mood of father now, because if you want to be my child, why can't I become a father of you? You are giving this post to me, why not? So I am so happy, I am so unlimited blissful by becoming your father, by seeing you, that you accept me as your father. But what to do, my dear child, the Supreme Lord? As a father, as a fatherly affection, the love, I have to protect my child. But see, I am such a conditioned state, I can't help, I can't protect you, my child. I know this Kamsa. In the present day, he is the supermost powerful demon in the whole planet. And I know, you know that, how cruel he is. He just heard 8 years before, he just heard from Akashvani, from the Devavani, that my 8th son, his sister's 8th child, will kill him. He just heard from nowhere. He can't find anybody. Some devatas, they make the sound. They gave information. Everybody heard that, the Akashvani, from sound coming from the sky, that, oh, Kamsa, this your sister to whom you are driving, his 8th son will kill you. Oh. From that moment, this cruel demon immediately was trying to kill his sister shamelessly. At the time of marriage, he was with proper dress code, you know, when marriage, after marriage, the day after marriage, they were in a special decorative dress, in proper sari, alankar, special sringar. In that position, and she was the younger sister of Kamsa, she didn't feel anything in the public. He went to kill her and was about to kill her. Somehow or other, I tried my best and I gave him promise. Oh, Kansa, Jivaraj, why are you killing to your sister? It is not good. Your sister is not your enemy. No, what she can do? She is not my enemy. His child, her child. Now then, I am promising you, whatever child, I will give it to you. So by this promise of mine, Kansa said, okay, go ahead. And because the eighth son will be the killer of him, he is so cruel, he never mind to kill all your elder brothers. Not a single one, he said, no, they are the number one, number two, the eighth is my case. Why you will take disturb? No. He was so cruel, he was so shameless. And he killed all your elder brothers, one by one, mercilessly. Newborn baby, he will take and smash into a rock. He was killing. And this time, because this is the eighth, child is coming. Kamsa now he is expert by figuring in calendar that how much time Devaki is taking to get another child. So in his calendar, it must be calculated that this will be the day. And every day he is getting report from the nurses, what is the position. And almost he knew that today or tonight something, the eighth child is, child will appear. So, and he has appointed many experienced armed guards around this jail. And specially warning them, the moment you heard the boy appear, immediately give me message. At that time there was no phone call, no smartphone or landline even. Otherwise they could have direct line contact. But night guards and day guards always alert. Any time the boy will appear, take birth, he will give message and Kansa will keep a special bonus to them. So Vasudeva is telling, oh my dear Lord, I am sure that these guards, they must have got the message that you already born. Though you never cried like ordinary children, any of us in the beginning, our opening starts with crying, isn't it? All of start our opening with a good crying. And all of us will close our closing in making others crying. And we think that in between we will laugh. So, but still, these guards are so experienced, so expert, they must have seeing from the window or somehow or other, they would get the trace that you burn, immediately run and give information to Kamsa, and Kamsa will must be running now, coming. He must be on the way. Yudhayudha, with weapons in his hand, raised sword, because this is the final match. This is the final match. He put us in jail and all arrangements because of you only. You are the target. And now you appeared. Oh. He must be running to come here immediately, and I know you are looking 100% 100% supreme lord. All your top to bottom, any foolish man say he is Lord Narayana. Anybody, because you are, all your appearance or is all limbs of your body or garments and smiling or your bodily appearance, everything is 100% prove that you are the supreme Lord. The other boys were not supreme, they are ordinary child, and he never excuse them, he killed them, all of them killed by him. The ordinary child, expecting they may be Narayana, but you are 100% Narayana, nothing mix. 100% Narayana you are, and if Kansa will come and see you, I can't imagine what, how much angry he will become, what kind of action he will take. He will kill you like anything. The super most attractive handsome baby, he will tell, oh my dear father Vasudev, do you think that Kamsa will come and kill me? I am so beautiful. I am so beautiful, so attractive. Even Kamsa will become attractive. He will never kill me. He said, no, this boy is, he should not be killed. Because I am so attractive and so beautiful. So, to answer this question of Lord, Vasudeva is telling, oh my Lord, I know, he is asabhya. Civilized person, they will understand, oh, he is so nice, how can I kill him? But he is not civilized. He is asabhya. The asabhyas, they have no shame, they have no culture. They are so cruel. They are ready to kill to anybody. Prabhupada in purport is saying, they are ready to kill cows, brahmanas, old men, children, women. No comparison. They are so bad, they are so. So he is, Kamsa is the head of the department of uncivilized person, cruel person. He will never scare you. He will definitely kill you. So that's why I am praying you, please, as soon as possible, withdraw this, your Narayana appearance. You become an ordinary child. At least something you can do. And I want, because I have fatherly affection, though by your mercy I can understand you are the Supreme Father, you are the Supreme Personality, what Kamsa, billions and trillions of Kamsa can do anything to you. They can do nothing to you. Are what they can do you? If one insect will take shelter of your lotus feet, even an insect, if will take shelter of your lotus feet, trillions and billions of demon like Kamsa can't approach him. Because he is taking shelter of your feet. Or what to speak of you, the Supreme Person. I know, if someone just take the shelter of your holy name, forget you, just take the shelter of your holy name, then they will be freed from the material encasement. They will get liberation. Just by chanting your holy name. Forget chanting, if they just meditate and chanting, they think of any qualities of you, any form of you, if they think of, then they will free from all the anxieties. And now you, not only name, form, quality, attributes, with everything you are here, with full form you are here. So, nobody can do anything. I should be convinced by that. But what can I do, my child? I am bewildered. Because I know, by your mercy, I know your opulence, by, I know your prowess, I know your power, but same time, because you have accepted me as your father, so as a dear father, I am also, my fatherly mood is coming, and in mood of father, I want to protect my child from this immediate danger is going to happen now by cancer. So I want to protect. So I'm totally bewildering position in both rasas, in Aishwarya and Vatsalya. In Vatsalya bhav, as a father, I want to help you, I want to protect you. But in Aishwarya bhav, I know this kansa is cannot be a mosquito in front of you. It is nothing. And I know that you appear just to give me pleasure, not me, to the giving the pleasure of the to the devotees. Though people are telling, no, the Lord is appearing for Bhubhara Haranaya, to take the burden of the earth. But I know, this is only excuse. Why you will come to, you personally will come to the, you can give a phone call from there, hey, do that. Anybody can do by your order. If you empowered a worm, for some purpose, the worm will become the superpower and win over the whole universe. By your empowerment, a worm can do that, an ant can do that. For this thing, you, oh Supreme Lord, you should not appear for this purpose. No, I know, you only appear because you have so much love for your devotees to exhibit, to love, to express your relation with the your devotees, so you personally appear. Otherwise, there is no reason to come in person. And specially, you want to be my son, Devaki Nandana. So that's why me, Vasudeva, is talking to Devaki Nandana now. You are our dear child. So to give us this position as a father and mother of yours, you appear personally here in the jail room, even in the night. So I am totally perplexed. The Kansa is about to appear with all his weapons to kill you, and that's why I am praying, oh my child, oh my Lord, so please do something that I can able to help you, to protect you. So please be a normal child one at least. Don't show your supremely Narayan form, please. So in this mood, Vasudeva is concluding his stuti, his prayers. And in the last, now the Sukadeva will start, now Devaki will start glorifying. And Vasudeva is almost in a mix, perplexion, in bewilderment. He is by opulence and by vatsalya, in both mood. He can't speak anything. He's just fearing with tremble, and also he's saying, no, nothing can happen. In the both the mood, he becomes speechless and is in folded hands, just looking at the supremely beauty of the newborn baby of Narayana inside, in front of him. Today it's also a special day. I want to say something about it, though I could have many things can be spoken in this context. But today is special day. Today is Margashirs Shukla Panchami. It is also considered as Vivaha Panchami. Vivaha Panchami means the marriage took place between Lord Ram and Sri Sita Devi today in this tithi. So that's why in this tithi, in Mithila, Nepal, and all in UP, that side, all the temples in the houses of all, they will do the special function. Vivaha Panchami. They will chant Ramayana, Balakand, and do Sitaram Vivaha, many things, big function, Vivaha Panchami. You know that mother Sita, she appeared in Janakpur as a daughter of Janak Maharaj. Janak is a title. His name was Shirodhvaja Janak, and his younger brother Kushadhvaja Janak. So Shirodhvaja Janak, for a sacrifice, big jagya, he was plowing. So somehow or other, that part which is plow, it's called Sita, this part. So from earth, one packet come out when he was plowing. When they opened it, they found the girl, such a beautiful young girl. So because come out from the that plowing, that part Sita, though they named her as Sita. And Janak Maharaj took her, and she was maintained by them, Nandabi and Janak Maharaj. One time, Sita Devi was growing. In their dynasty, in Janak Maharaj dynasty, maybe 10 or 15 generations before, King Devarat was there in Janak Raj. So Lord Shiva, he gave one bow, Shiva Dhanush. He said, just keep it. Actually, that Dhanush, Lord Shiva was becoming angry when Satidah, when Dakhya Jagya, in a Dakhya sacrifice, when Sati burnt herself, Shiva, he sent his messenger, and they totally devastate this Jagya field, everything, and Shiva became so angry, he personally came with his heavy bow, and he angrily started dancing. All the demigods were looking. He said, you demigods, you are taking part in this sacrifice, I supposed to take part, but you people never allowed me. You never invited me. This Dakhya also never invited me. He is killed already. So I want to kill all of you. Cut all your heads by this Dhanush. Then Devatas immediately fearful. They come and offer stuti. Oh my dear Lord, please excuse us. Please excuse us. So then Asutosh became pacified. He said, okay, you are saying I will not kill you. Then he says, Dhanush, because I brought to kill you people, you are now saying no, please don't kill us, so I want to give it away. So he gave it to Devarat, king, Devarat in the Janak dynasty. So that Dhanush was there, that Shiva Dhanush. And it was such a heavy Dhanush, it was described that they were to transport it with 8-wheel cart, huge cart, you know, bullock cart with 2 wheels, big wheels, iron wheels, the 8 wheels, big 1 kilometer long cart. And there these few thousands of soldiers, they will bring it, such a heavy bow. And it was there in the temple, Dhanur Mahal, Dhanur Kakhya, the huge hall, stadium, the Dhanush was keeping there. One time, Sita, she was a girl, young, youth time, she was playing with some of her friends. She went to that Dhanur Kakhya, Dhanur Griha, and she saw that, why nobody is cleaning here? And why it is not clean? That will be because this heavy Dhanush is there. Once in a year, some people, they will take it, move it, so then they will clean it. Why? They can't take that Dhanush and clean it. She was young girl. She went in her left hand, take this Dhanush and clean it. And the other friend, they saw it. They run and they inform it to Janak. Oh, Maharaj, this is once in a yearly festival to take this bow, and now your daughter Sita, she took and left her out and cleaned the place. What are you saying? Janak said, how can it be possible? He said, come and see. And he came already, she kept that Dhanush in the place, but the room was clean. He said, who cleaned it? No, Papa, I cleaned it. How come? No, it was filthy. It was not clean, so I cleaned it. But how able to? No, they are saying the Dhanush, so I took it out and cleaned it. Jarang Maharaj take his deep breathing. You did it now? Yes. Playingly, playfully I did it. So Janak Maharaj decided, if my daughter Sita is so strengthened, so powerful, few thousand soldiers, they can move it. And see her with her left hand, take it out like playfully. Now she is about to approach her marriageable age. Who will marry her? Such a powerful, such a strengthy girl. We should find a proper mias for her. So then he decided, at least some proper person, matching boy should be there. So he announced, Biryasulka, if somebody can compete, take the bow up and put the string on it, then he can able to marry my daughter. And throughout India, all big potential powerful kings and princes, they came, but none of them able to hold it and pick it. And they said, and they became angry, they want to fight with Janak. I say, you are making us fool. This is not possible by everybody. No one can do it, and you are making us fool. Who will marry your daughter? They are able to fight. Janak Maharaj said, oh, there big fighting happened. Somehow or other, at that time, the Supreme Lord, Ram and Lakshman, with Vishwamitra, because they invited the Swayamvar, they went. They never went for that purpose. They went to just see. Vishwamitra took them, and Vishwamitra explained about this Sivadhanus. They became very excited to see that. Oh, my dear Vishwamitra ji, please request the king. We want to see that dhanus. We want to see that. Then Janak Maharaj said, oh, this young two boys, what, they'll big soldiers, big king, powerful kings, they do nothing. Why they want to see? No, they just want to see. They are not taking photographs. Photographs prohibited anyway. There is no camera at that time. But still they just want to see it. So just please allow them to see. So then Janak Maharaj said, okay, take them to Dhanurgriha, because it is not difficult to bring them. Big arrangement required to bring dhanus here. They can go to that room. So then they became very curious. Both Ram and Lakshman went. And then Vishwamitra, all the Brahman, everybody followed them, because these two boys were the center of attraction, the whole Mithila. Everybody was looking at them. They were so attractive, two boys. So when these two boys went to Dhanurgriha, so everybody followed them. And they went, then saw it. The Janak Maharaj said, you want to have a close darshan? No, yes, little more close. No? So then he closed. So, my dear king, don't mind, can I touch? Okay, touch. You are a young man, what can I touch? See? So, can I also see nicely? Okay. So then Lord Ram also in his left hand pick it up. What? Everybody, even King Janak, everybody, oh, you pick it up. And they said, not only pick it, everybody to make everybody with full wonder. Lord Ram put the string, and he was put the string, and he was taking a trial. And so powerfully he moved it, it broke down from the middle. With huge sound broke down. Oh, many of them were fainted down somehow or other. And it is Janak Maharaj and others, they never in a dream that this boy could do this. Then Lord Ram, excuse me, this old one, that's why I broke down. I didn't mean to break. I never mind will break. It was old one, a rutted one, it broke down. So excuse me, don't mind. So, but then Janak Maharaj said, now my daughter, so Sita Devi come with Kalyan and the marriage. So then the Vishwamitra, Vasishta, Javali, Katyayana, Satananda, all these big Trikaladarshi Mahatma rishis were there. He said, stop, we will have a really marriage function. So you have two daughters, Sita and Urmila, and your younger brother Kushadhaja have two daughters also. So they are four Kumaras, Ram, Lakshman, Shatrughna, Varsu, all of them together. Today is Ditya. After 3 days in the Panchami Tithi, all four of them will marry all four of your daughter. So then this function happened in this Margasi Shukla Panchami in Mithila, in Janakpur. And huge ceremony, Vivaha ceremony happened. So that is, so this Tithi is special Tithi. Lord Sitaram and Lakshman, Urmila, and all of them, the four Kumaras, the four princes, they married today. And in particular, in Braj area, this day is called, is celebrated not as Vivaha Panchami, this is celebrated as Bihar Panchami. Bihar Panchami means, today is the appearance of the Bihari Jivanka Bihari, the famous deity of Vrindavan. Today is the day of his appearance day. You know Swami Haridas, the famous singer, even in Akbar's assembly, the famous singer Tansen, who can sing and even the rain will start, Ragamalhar. And his guru, Tansen's guru is Swami Haridas. Around 300 or 400 years before, he was there. And it is described that Haridas was non-different from Lalita Devi. He was incarnation of Lalita Ji. And he used to go every day to Nidhivan. In a particular place in Nidhivan, he will sit and chant special raga. And whole day he forget eating and sleeping, he will chant there only. So he has many disciples, followers. One of his nephew called Bipul Dev. One day all of them came and said, Guruji, why you are every day coming to this particular place and you are spending the whole day? What is the secret? Then he said, okay, in due time you will see it. So after some day, in this particular tithi, this is the appearance, the birthday of Vipul Dev also. He has birthday. So then Swami Haridas called all of them. He said, come today. So they come and said, go to that place where I used to sit, go to this place and see. So they curiously, all of them, people go somewhere, everybody they went. And they could not see, they almost become blind. It was so effulgent, so bright, light is coming from that place. So bright, they couldn't see it. They come back and say, we can't able to see. What is going on, what is special? Then Swami Haridas said, come, follow me. Swami Haridas went, sit down there, and started chanting the prayers. Then slowly the light come to one particular place and the Supreme Lord appeared there in front of them. In person, the Supreme Lord appeared. Though all these jnanis, all these big people, they know that the Supreme Lord is impersonal Brahma, all-pervasive, everywhere he is. But that unlimited, all-pervasive Supreme Lord becomes, accept limitation, becomes limited and becomes audible. Anybody can see him and he is a form, proper, like a human form. He appeared and in front of Haridas to accept his service and to give his audience to his followers and devotees. He appeared in this particular tithi. That place is called Bihariji Prakatyasthal, Nidhivan. You can see that place. So then Bihariji with ceremony, he took their deity to the temple of Bihariji and established there. And today, as the appearance of Sivanka Bihariji, as the Bihar Panchami, the big festival will happen, all these followers of Ardasi Goswami, Sivanka Bihari Goswami, from the morning today, they will all go to the Prakatyasthal of Nidhivan. There is huge abhishek will happen in the morning, already happened. They will take the footprint of Bihariji with the procession and the huge abhishek, Panchamrita abhishek there in Nidhivan, in Prakatyasthal. And then after abhishek, the big procession will start from there to Bihariji temple with elephants, bands and many parties of singing and kirtan and all that. By noon time, by 12 o'clock, they will reach in Bihariji temple and then Rajbhog offering. They believe that Swami Haridas personally will appear and offer bhoga to Bihariji and keeping Bihariji in her lap. He will feed him. So that Rajbhog Arati will be today the appearance day of the birthday of Sri Banke Bihariji. It's called Bihar Panchami. Huge festival and big ceremony procession will happen today throughout the market. They will come to Biharji temple by noon time. So this thing is taking place in Braj area. So this in Braj area, this Panchami is famous as Bihar Panchami, not as Vivaha Panchami. So we are describing here in the Bhagavatam the Supreme Lord appear in person in the jail in Mathura in front of Vasudeva and Devaki. The Supreme Lord appear in Nidhivan in front of Swami Haridas as Bihariji. And the Supreme Lord also appeared and get married to Sita Devi in this tithi. Hare Krishna. Samaveta Bhakta Vrindaki. Yes. Any comments or any question? After that, yeah, of course, when Madan Mohan appeared, when Sanatan Goswami, there was nobody was here, almost desert area. I told that say 300 is over there, 500 is before. Okay. Anything else? Yes.
You mentioned Tansen.
What? Tansen, yeah. Yes. Yeah, disciple of Haridas.
Disciple of Swami Haridas.
Yes. Okay. Granthas Srimad Bhagavat Mahapurana ki Samveta Bhakta Vrinda ki Jai.